Good day. This is Lex 2037, Dr. Sherlock's home. We are from Group 4. I'm Lim Pek Sia with matrix number 175649.
Hi, good day. My name is Uma Shafushanmugam, matrix number 174212.
Hi, my name is Jeremani Kupusami and my matrix number is 175669.
Hello, my name is Petrina N. Vintipita, matrix number 171804.
Hi, my name is
Assalamualaikum. My
name is Hidayatul Dabilah binti Mak Yasin. My matric number is 175089. Okay. Okay, good. Today our discussion is on our experience on foodborne infection.
Yep.
So I'm sure everyone has exposed to any foodborne infection before.
Yes.
Food poisoning? Anyone?
Yeah. Once I think I was 8, yeah, that was what, about, how old I am now, 22, that was about 14 years ago, yeah. So what happened was my mom and my grandma went to India, so my brother and I were left with my aunties, under auntie's care. She just got married, so she doesn't really know how to cook. So she made fish curry, but the fish wasn't cooked enough. So what happened was, after eating, I think about 2 hours or 3 hours later, we started having all kind of symptoms, like, I don't know what to say, it's like all kind of, you know, this feelings in your stomach, it's like you're feeling everything's like crushing up and everything. And then suddenly we had like vomiting at the same time, diarrhea, it was so bad. So what happened was, since we were in kampung, we were back in village, back in hometown, so my auntie brought us to one of the traditional medicine person. So she gave us like thick tea, what do you call that?
Concoction.
Yeah, it's concoction, yeah. After, I don't know whether that worked or just my immunity worked. I was okay after a few days. Yeah. So bad.
How old are you by then?
I was 8, I think.
Oh,
yeah.
Very awful.
Yes, I vomited here since I pushed here and then I had diarrhea in the back. It was so bad. It was so bad. I can't really remember, but it started night. Night?
Were you the only one affected?
My brother was even worse.
I think she was.
I'm not sure if she ate or not.
She's
maybe she got immune to it.
I had a similar experience.
Hospital? No, because it was like, it was like hometown, right? It was hometown, so back in like a small Felga village. They had clinic kesihatan KK, but we don't really go there. My auntie was more traditional, so she probably had it. I don't know if that worked or just my body took over. I don't know which one worked.
I also had a similar experience. Well, what happened was my whole family went out and ate somewhere. I don't know what we ate. Can't remember what specifically what we ate. But then the thing is, the whole family, like me, my brother, my parents, everyone came down with diarrhea and vomiting for like a few days. And I vomited like until your bile comes out, because at the end of the day, you know, it's like super bad that, you know, I had to go to the hospital. Thank God we were not admitted, but I was so dehydrated. Then the doctor gave us, doctor just asked us to, I think he gave us like some antibiotics. And then just take, you know, like you have to take 100 plus to dehydrate your body. That's the basic treatment they usually do, is they ask you to take 100 plus. That was my experience.
When was that?
I think when I was 14 or 15, around that age. But the whole family come. Whole family is like one after another, no, like one person goes to use the bathroom, next person. You know, it was like that, and then it was like
God.
A very bad experience.
Such messy period.
That was like the worst period in my life. But other than that, I think we always have diarrhea in college. But that was the worst.
Wow.
Anyone else want to share that?
I went. It just happened recently that I went to a ruminant farm.
Okay.
I think it's quite messy over there. When you go there and then you have close contact with the cattle, and then sometimes they are dung.
Yeah.
Are just all over the place, and it's wet and it's moist. And then their tail just sweeps here and there.
Okay.
And then you're at the back doing pregnancy diagnosis.
Alright.
Then that's when I'm not sure if something touched my face or something, and then it just kind of entered the mouth. I'm not sure. But then after that, it just diarrhea all night long. So many episodes that I just cannot stand properly. I went to a clinic nearby, which is not nearby. A few 15 km away.
You sure it was because of the cattle, not because of something you ate, or you didn't eat anything after
that? Yes, my other friends are okay. Just I think it's the unhygienic. Yeah, it was not really a nice experience.
I think I also had the same experience because I studied at boarding school, but then we ate at the eating hall together, but that night only I got the stomach ache and feel like want to vomit and everything, but everyone else is fine, so I think it's only me. But the whole night you cannot sleep because you keep going to the toilet, and until you had nothing to come out because that's too much
already.
And the worst part is there's no one want to send you to the hospital in the middle of the night, because at the boarding school you got the warden, but they just ask you to rest because it's already middle of the night. I don't think they want to send student, right? Because it's only one student.
One of you eat the same.
Yeah, because we eat at the same pool, but
do you remember what food did you eat?
I think just the normal menu, the rice and the fish. But I don't remember exactly what the food is.
Can be evil because that specific part of the meat or something got contaminated, or just your immunity was not on your side.
Or maybe the utensil, the fridge.
Because I just got into that school thing. That's why I'm not used to it.
Oh,
it's a
little
bit of that only me.
It's quite bad. Anyone else with any experience?
I had one that around last December. I ate food from K17 cafes. So it's for dinner actually. So right away that night I had diarrhea, and then at first I'm not suspecting anything, but then the next day I went to the cafe again, and I realized in the afternoon maybe they cooked the food, I'm not sure how, but I found something
in the food.
Yes.
What
kind of
stuff? A maggot? A worm?
Oh, what kind of worm?
It's in the fish. Catfish.
Catfish?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Catfish.
I think they did not take care of the hygiene.
You mean maggot? Yes. Like maggot or the vegetable worm?
The fish actually eat the worms.
Oh, you mean they didn't clean it up?
Yeah. Oh my god, that's disgusting.
Oh, you mean it's a lot, not just one.
Oh,
gross. I've literally seen worm in my food. I was like, oh my god, I cannot eat. It's like midway of eating. Midway, and then I see a worm there. I'm like, no, of course not. Their food, even we can't eat. You think the worm is going to survive eating your food? So the worm was dead. I looked at it, I was like, oh my goodness, okay, pack up everything, throw it away. I guess.
Yeah,
yeah.
I think
I couldn't eat after that. It's who would even eat after that?
Oh yeah, for the diarrhea that I had, I just ate grilled chicken.
Chicken on. I've never heard of it until like a few days back.
I think it's still aggressively effective.
Because scaling pectin actually takes some time, right, to stop the diarrhea.
So, did you have any episodes of food poisoning?
I'm not sure is that because of food poisoning or what. Because during my SSC year, I live in KPZ, you know, Forest Minister Sabah, and I always bought food from there. So I don't know why it was on one day that suddenly I feel stomachache, and then I just having diarrhea like more than 5 times. I went to the toilet and it's like shooting diarrhea. I think it was, yeah, you can imagine it when you went to the toilet and it just. Yeah, just come out like that. So I don't usually go to the clinic or what because I don't really like to go there, but because I cannot stand it anymore, so I have to go to PK by myself. So
the clinic was just opposite the food court, but
I really lazy to go there because I think but in that situation I think I'm desperate, so I think I have to go there to solve the problems. Yeah.
So it's when you have that kind of area, I don't think you want to walk.
You don't want to take the risk of walking and making your intestines move more.
And getting further away from the toilet.
Yes! That's it. The worry.
Thank you, Sasha, for that. Explain to doctor what kind of mold that you have, what the texture, that conversation that the doctor will ask you. So I think it's such a bother to answer. So I'm not sure, is it because of food or what? Because I think I always bought at the same place, so I'm not sure.
Probably
the
time the food that they prepare is the one that you order.
Maybe once in a time.
Do you remember what kind of medication?
I'm not sure. It just. And also like the salt water.
The carbonated one, isotonic.
Wait, the one with sachets?
Yeah,
in
the orange
one.
Layers.
That one. I think that's like a standard taste.
Nasty. No!
You don't drink that one.
So.
What causes all these? You know, since you have studied our public health, you study so many kind of bacteria. What kind of bacteria actually is inside there that causes us to purge and diarrhea?
I can remember it's not because we did the assignment, and they said Salmonella was one of the cause. And they said because the duration is about 2 to 3, the duration, the incubation period for that particular species. The particular agent is about 2 to 3 days, if I'm not mistaken.
Typhi,
right? No. Enteritis.
Enteritis is about 2 to 3 days.
And then after that, the duration itself, and then you get that diarrhea, vomiting, and all the. That's the incubation period. Duration can last up to a few days, about 10 days or 11 days. You have diarrhea, vomiting, you know that. Sometimes it's not necessarily immediately after you eat, you get diarrhea. It's like, you know, after 2 days, 3 days, then you get your diarrhea because the bacteria needs time to
proliferate and also, you know, to multiply and all that. You know, kind of, that was the one that
usually it's like, it's not just because of the agent, it's also as well due to the toxin that we produce.
Mm-hmm.
Usually if it's because of the toxin, then the reaction will be faster, rather than the agent itself going into your intestines and infecting them, causing inflammation, and then moving on to diarrhea and all the symptoms. So it can be either both toxins and the agents as well.
So basically, intoxication, the reaction is shorter than infection, right?
Yeah.
Because infection usually it takes sometimes a few days for it to occur to show the symptoms.
Yeah. Because the bacteria would want to multiply inside and produce the toxins, and then only it gets into our body and gets diarrhea.
I think diarrhea
is
supposed to have
liver
dysfunction.
Oh yes.
Definitely. Those, the fever is like a,
actually fever is like your own body kind of compact.
Yeah, that's when so your inflammation like, all happens, that's when you get your fever. It will happen.
We should like, don't talk about, know what community or authorities can do.
To reduce the incidence of food poisoning.
Yeah.
So what do you think we can do as a community?
Maybe in, you mean in terms of community? Okay, so for community, maybe we can think about like if there is any dirty premises, then the people can boycott. I mean, like what I mean by premises, like restaurants or something like that. So people, like, you know, when I say boycott, that means they do not go.
I think probably when they heard news about that place that had been boycotted, so I think what you want to say is that people should also like don't go to that place for some time so that
So they improve level of hygiene. Yeah.
Actually, do you think boycotting is effective? Because if people stops going there and there are new people going there, it's still the same. The place won't know that their food has caused diarrhea.
No, but I think like everyone agrees to boycott the place, you post it on Facebook or Twitter and everything. So if everybody agrees to boycott that area, that the people themselves, I mean the owners will definitely take action to try to improve their cleanliness and food special method.
Maybe we can direct
Maybe we can report to the consumer office or something. You have Ministry of Health one, and I think you also have the consumer complaint.
Consumer rights.
Yes, you have the consumer rights. There's a word for it.
Hak pengguna.
But the process is very long.
Yes, definitely. Oh yes,
definitely. No complaint, consumer complaint.
Have you guys seen a piece of paper on every restaurant? They say grade A or grade B. So is it part of the measures to combat this food poisoning issue?
I think because as I know, the grade have been ensure that the premise have been observed by the Ministry of Health, and their cleanliness level have been evaluated by them, and then I think grade A means that they have the best their cleanliness is really great. So I think it is better to choose the grade A premise to eat there, so the probability for us to get the foodborne disease or intoxication is really low. But in case we have, if we eat them and we still have the problem, so I think that's why we should do the complaints. Like they don't really deserve to get that grade, so this means there's something wrong.
I also think, like, you know, instead of authorities, we also should, as a consumer ourselves, we also should take precautionary steps now to make sure that you don't get diarrhea. First thing I think you should do is like, you know, like when you buy a product, you should just like check the expiry date and all that. It's like,
other than the expiry date, maybe can you sell
the cans actually? Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Yeah. And sometimes they are rusty actually.
Yeah.
But there's some, you know, like I've heard that sometimes they also say, like, you know, you shouldn't buy too fresh a product.
Oh.
Let's say let's say for vegetables or fruits, right? If it's too fresh, that means that they're using some kind of chemicals to make it look fresh. Usually vegetables should have like some kind of like, you know, like
bite marks
and holes and I don't know. That means that shows that the product's organic, true. I don't know, I just want to say something.
Yeah, I think
true.
As a consumer, maybe instead of buying at the restaurant, maybe when you are outside, so that we have more confidence in what we eat.
Oh, yes, true.
Yeah, I think when we cook our own food. So I think maybe we can ensure every process from what I cleaning the food and so on until it depends on what it is most healthy. But maybe if there is also the case of food intoxication or disease happen, maybe it is our own wrong in a longer process.
But you know, to grow vegetables, we need like land, that's the thing. I think we are so modernized that, you know, when we buy a house, we don't really think about land space. Some of us are staying in apartments, you know, that kind of thing.
Well, sometimes we can do is we can buy vegetable raw materials and then we can cook ourselves. That's more practical.
Yeah, that's true. That's a common way, right? You're using.
Yeah. But now, like, you know, we're college students, it's a bit hard to cook.
Oh, yes.
We are restricted by the college rules.
Yeah.
I agree, Susan.
So another. So probably we can conclude that foodborne infection, to prevent it, is both. I mean, the roles are being played by both community, which is us basically, as well as the authorities, which can be either NGOs or government authorities. So with that, we thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.